Most of us know we should be prepared for anything, but the reality is we can sometimes feel woefully unequipped to handle all the curveballs life throws our way. Let's face it, sometimes it is hard to be a grown-up. And some of the time we are so focused on ensuring our children learn their own life skills that we forget to make sure we're learning the life skills we need for our family. Just think about the most successful people in the world. Those who consistently succeed are those who are the best at learning new things. Successful people make the commitment to dedicate their spare time in the pursuit of learning, and they stick to their promise of learning. With that in mind, these are the 10 skills everyone should learn in life. Number 1, learn how to show empathy. Want to understand someone? Walk a mile in their shoes? Or so the old saying goes. But how to actually show empathy in the real world generally doesn't involve footwear. What it does involve is learning how to be a good listener and how to comfort and reassure others without being creepy or patronizing. Get better at empathizing with others. The importance of learning to empathize with other people, to listen to them and try to see things from their perspective. Number 2, learn how to apologize. Whether intentionally or not, people hurt each other all the time. Here are some examples of how you may have hurt or offended someone in the past. You forgot a loved one's birthday. You said something critical and uncalled for. You were rude to someone. When you hurt someone else, you're going to have to apologize. In addition, you're going to have to apologize the right way. To have an effective apology, you need to acknowledge the offense, explain what happened, express remorse, apologize, explain how to avoid the problem in the future, make restitution. The apology needs to be sincere, not qualified, not quantified, and also needs to outline how X will not happen again. Number 3, learn how to say no. Don't let fear make you agree to everything. Many of us fear saying the word no because we don't want to let other people down. But when you're already swamped and your coworker asks you to take an hour to help him with his project report, yes, of course, might not be the best answer. For such a short word, it's amazing how many of us have a hard time saying it. But learning how to graciously but firmly say no without padding it with excuses or white lies is a critical life skill. If you're one of those people who automatically says yes, when someone asks you to do something and feels guilty saying no, try saying, "I need to think about it," instead. That will give you time to think through your schedule and decide if it's something you can really do without the pressure of having the person's pleading eyes boring into you. And remember, every time you say yes to one thing, like working late, you're also saying no to everything else, like the gym, dinner with your family, and a reasonable bedtime. Number 4, learn how to understand consequences. Want to party but not wake up with a hangover? Stuff yourself with cake but not gain weight? Take off every Friday but still have a job on Monday? Speed but never get a ticket? Well, we're sorry to be the ones to break this to you, but this is not the way the world works, usually. We all know this on an intellectual level, and yet we rage against it on an emotional level, living as if we don't understand the immutable law of consequences. So here you go. When you make a choice to do something, you are also choosing the consequence. It's a package deal. Number 5, learn how to persuade others. It's important to know how to get others to say yes to your requests, whether it's a request for someone to buy your products, a request to your boss for flex time, a request to your neighbor to stop parking so close to the curb, and so on. By learning the principles that guide human behavior and applying these principles ethically, you can significantly increase the chances that you'll get what you want. The 6 principles of influence or persuasion are the following: reciprocity, commitment, social proof, liking, authority, scarcity. Number 6, learn how to accept criticism. You did something wrong? Congratulations, you're human. Unfortunately, we often treat mistakes as personal failures, which makes hearing about them upsetting, to put it mildly. And when others try to offer criticism, it can unleash your inner Hulk. But if you can teach yourself to see mistakes as learning opportunities instead, it makes them and the inevitable criticism that comes with them so much easier to handle. An amazing skill, which you can learn through practice, is to set aside your emotional response in the moment and focus on the information presented to you. Some of it will be valid and some of it invalid, but let your brain decide that, not your ego. Depending on what kind of feedback you're receiving, there are different strategies for responding with a cool head. For example, if your boss points out what she thinks is an error and you're not sure she's correct, you can say, "I hadn't thought of that and I'm going to look into it right away." Number 7, learn how to cope with change. You know what they say, the only constant in life is change, yet many of us still live our lives like they'll always stay the same. So when big changes come, they can rock the very foundation of our lives. But you don't need to fear change, you just need to be prepared for it. Come up with a concrete plan for major contingencies and you'll save yourself a lot of worry. Number 8, learn how to set goals. Your goals direct your behavior so that you can achieve what you want from life. If you don't have goals, your life will lack direction. The acronym SMART has stuck around for a long time because it works. Make your goals SMART: specific, measurable, actionable, realistic, time-bound. Number 9, learn how to manage time. There will probably never be a time in your life when you aren't juggling multiple personal and professional priorities. Time management skills are a must, unless you want to feel constantly frazzled. Perhaps the most important time management lesson is that you should stick with one task at a time. Research suggests that multitasking is generally counterproductive because the brain expends energy as it readjusts its focus from one activity to another. Without learning basic time management skills, you'll never be able to achieve what you want. Basic time management skills include the following: learning how to prioritize, getting organized, creating a schedule, overcoming procrastination, doing one thing at a time. You'd be wise to limit your hours you spend working. Decades ago, Henry Ford discovered that the productivity started to decline after employees logged more than 40 hours per week. Other research suggests that after 3 weeks, 60-hour work weeks become less productive. Number 10, learn how to find contentment. You know the saying that happiness attracts more happiness? I think it applies to contentment too. Actively opting to be content leads to more contentment. But here is where the pattern differs, because the more content you are with your life, the more likely you are to find and experience happiness. Learning about these skills will allow us to live happier and more successful and fulfilling lives. There are countless things you can learn in your spare time that can dramatically improve your personal and professional life. These things will help you understand your true potential and boost your confidence.